Hey, what's up everybody? This is Superbrick501 and today I want to show you guys a Zane boss killing build. And like I said in my last build video, I wanted to do two builds for every character in the game. One that's completely focused on mobbing and one that is completely focused on killing bosses. And I want to make these builds very high roll builds. So there's a lot of really good rolls. There's some god rolls in here. They're going to be really hard to get these builds at this power level because of how good the items are, all the anointed rolls, stuff like that. So this one is going to be the Zane boss killing build. So let's go into the talents. Now what's pretty cool about this build is that it is really similar to my last Zane build, which is more focused on mobbing. It uses majority of the same items, pretty much the same talent setup. It's just a change of the main weapon using, which that change is pretty big because you can one-shot majority of the bosses without immunity phases, and you can even skip some immunity phases just because of how much damage you can actually put out or how much burst you can put out. So if you want a more in-depth explanation into some of these items, the start of my last Zane video goes over that. You'll still know how this build works just watching this video. So first off, for our first tree, we're going doubled agent because we need the double barrel talent for our digi clone. Synchronicity, which gives you damage increase per action skill active. Then we have increased magazine size 3 out of 3. Then 5 in the Donnybrook, which is a kill skill, which gives you increased damage and health regen. It stacks twice and it gives both you and your clone this. And since we're using the C&D class mod, our kill skills will be up all of the time. And all of our kill skills are more powerful than the talent card actually shows because of the 25% from our Seeing Dead class mod and another 25% from something else. So this is actually much stronger. This is one of the biggest talents that we can get for damage and survivability. The regen is pretty good as well. Fractal Frags, this is mainly just used for as a kill skill when a prox, your clone has a chance to throw a grenade, which with any seeking grenade that your clone doesn't have a chance to miss with will actually add quite a bit of damage because you're constantly getting these procs and he'll just be throwing grenades everywhere. Duct Tape mod, this is mainly to get lower in the tree. This is a chance to shoot out a grenade the first round of every magazine for you. Quick Breather, this is really good for mobbing, but it's not super important for boss killing because your clone really isn't going to be taking a ton of damage most of the time. And this just pretty much makes you get shield recharged instantly when you switch with your clone, which is the important part because you want your shield up as much as possible because of the shield we're using, but it also heals your clone up to 50% of his max health. Then we have Pocketful Grenades. This gives you grenade regen as a kill skill that attacks twice. We only need one because this is mainly just to have 3 grenades. You could switch us off, but it's mainly to make sure you have boom enhance, especially with immunity fights. You might need to summon your digiclone multiple times, so you always want to consume up to 3 grenades to get these massive buffs, which pretty much buffs everything for your digiclone. Supersonic Man, with every action skill active, you gain movement speed, which is really good. Does increase our damage with some other talents. Trick of the Light, Zane deals a bonus crowd damage to enemies that aren't targeting him, which is really good as well with Digiclone because your Digiclone does taunt, which we'll go over in a second. Then Double Barrel, whatever weapon you have out when you summon your Digiclone is a weapon your Digiclone is using, which is very important for the build. And then you get increased damage when swapping places with your clone, which just is extra damage. So for a clone, we're using Digiclone with whatever this talent's name is called. Whenever your clone takes damage, Zane's shields are restored by a portion of that damage, which is very good because we are using an amp shield. And which one's a real one? Whenever you summon your clone or swap places with it, it has a kind of soft taunt, which helps with Trick of the Light, which will just give you more damage and also helps with you not taking as much damage. Now, for the rest of our talents, we're going into Hitman, mainly for all the kill skills active in this tree. So we have Violent Speed, Sacks Twice gives you movement speed, which is massive. It gives more than 60%, which it shows on the card because of our increases. So this is a massive movement speed increase, which gives us increased damage with Violent Momentum, which gives you gun damage increase. The faster you're moving, the more gun damage you get. It's 20% default walk speed, so it can be a pretty big damage increase with our movement speed kill skills and other talents. One into Cool Hand. This is mainly for reloading. If you're in an immunity fight, you're going to have to reload at some point because we don't have direct ammo regen into our magazine, so you're going to have to reload. This just helps with increased reload speed then off kill skill, which is going to be up all the time. You get more reload speed. It's just a little bit of a help. You can go more into this if you feel like you need it, but I don't think you need it any more than this for the boss fights in the game. Salvation, 3 points. It is a life steal kill skill, which will be up all the time, so it's 9% at 3. You could probably even do less than this because of how much damage you're going to do just off a single shot. It's going to instantly full heal you. So if you want something else, you could go less into this. Probably even 1 point is going to be fine, especially for most of the boss fights. Then death follows close. You gain kill skill bonus plus 25%, and then kill skill duration plus 7 seconds, helping you make sure this is up all the time and increasing all your kill skills. Then we went playing dirty five into this, which gives our extra shot. This is a kill skill that your five next projectiles have a chance to shoot an additional one. If you're 100% plus, it's a guaranteed chance. I did the extra. If I did one less, I think it'd be 90 or 95%, but I wanted to make sure it's at least 100% to make sure you have that guaranteed extra shot, especially for this build with the weapon you're using, because every shot of this weapon just does so much damage. So having this is a really big damage increase, and this is going to be up pretty much all the time with the weapon we're using. It's pretty much always going to be an additional projectile because it's a kill skill and will constantly be proccing. Then good misfortune, a kill skill, but again, we're going to be proccing kill skills from shooting enemies, increases your action skill duration, has diminishing returns. But with this, with how many procs we're getting, pretty much the entirety of every boss fight, your digi clone and your clone should be up a majority of the time, unless there's long immunity phases where you can't shoot anything. But it still should be up a majority of the time for a majority of the fights, at least ones you're not one-shotting, because most of the fights that don't have immunity phases, you're one-shotting anyway. And for this, we're using our drone with bad dose for just some extra buffs, movement speed, fire rate, stuff like that. And then static field, it drains enemy shields and gives you some shields back, which is also really good because we're using an amp shield. So now we can go into the items. So like I said, we're using a lot of the same items I used in my last Zane build that was more based on mobbing. So first off, you need the redundant face puncher because you need your digiclone using this for your ammo regen. And that goes with the cut purse class mod, which your digiclone will also take the stats and effects from. So anytime your digiclone shoots the face puncher at an enemy, when you have your rocket launcher out, which is the main thing we're using, you will get pretty much your entire magazine back because the face puncher is considered times 14 melee if you have a redundant, times 7 if you don't. But you'll pretty much get all of your ammo back, not in the magazine, but your overall ammo for the rocket launcher. So it's pretty much infinite ammo. I do really like the planetoid part of this, which is the legendary effect, because your clone is using a face puncher. This deals 69% bonus elemental damage with every melee attack, and it changes elements, so it's just additional damage. There could be some other good legendary effects that you could put on this to maybe get some extra damage, but this is a pretty good one to have. Magazine size is nice, so you don't have to reload as much. Electrocute chance and grenade damage are all pretty good. They're going to give you some decent damage increase. The grenade damage increase will help with your drone or your digiclone, because it's constantly throwing grenades everywhere, so that'll help a bit with that. Class mod, as I went over, the Seeing Dead class mod. We have weapon damage, grenade damage, and sniper damage. This could be slightly better, but this is by far the best one I found. The weapon damage is always good. Grenade damage for your digiclone's grenades again, and sniper alpha damage, we're not using a sniper, so that's what could be better with this. The rolls for the talents are pretty good in my opinion. The fire rate isn't really used for this particular weapon, but it's still good. Donnybrook and the extra projectile kill skill, all pretty good to go into. Now the shield is super, super important. It's a super giant version O.M, which it doesn't show it, but it is a amp shield, and it has 125% increased damage for I think 20 or 25% of your shields, with on the extra skill for bonus crowd damage. But mainly the shield itself, the amp is massive, and with how much shield regen effects we have, we are constantly able to get amp shot after amp shot after amp shot, which is super important for longer fights, immunity fights, fights that without immunities, as you'll see in the video, you're pretty much one-shotting most of them. And this is also pretty good because if you or your drone, or if you and your digiclone get their shields broken, it will drop a ring below them, which give you I think 25 or 30% increased damage when standing in it, and your clone will constantly have a shield broken, so we constantly have a ring blown, and you could switch spaces with him and you'll be in the ring now. So it's a good bit of damage increase from that as well. Grenade, anything that seeks out enemies, so hunter seekers seek enemies, anything that has tracking, stuff like that, where your clone can't miss when throwing a grenade, is mainly what you want. The on action skill end effects on the grenade and the shield are good, but they're not going to be that active. Like your abilities stay up so much that they're not going to be proc that many times. And that takes us to the main weapon, ion cannons. Now the ion cannons were massively nerfed. These consume consume seven ammo per shot and are times two. That's why they consume more ammo. They have a really slow reload time now because they nerfed that as well. But with this build, the fights that you can one shot, you're pretty much one shotting, so non-immunity boss fights. And fights with immunities, the reload speed doesn't matter as much. But with this specific build, you have infinite ammo, so the massive ammo per shot doesn't matter as much because we're constantly getting infinite ammo from our digiclone shooting stuff, just instantly filling our rocket launcher ammo back up. So that's pretty much the entire build. Subscribe if you want to see more Borderlands 3 content. Leave a like if you liked the video. Leave a comment down below if you guys have any questions about where to get any of these items, how the build works, anything like that. Leave it in the comments. I will have a save file if anyone on a PC wants this build, wants these items. You can download it in the description. And thanks for watching.
On my way! It's true!
Thief!
Hours for Maya!